Here we are, episode one of YouTube 102. And the very first thing we're gonna do, of course, is uploading a video to YouTube. The first thing I like to do here is check in the corner to make sure I'm logged in as who I want to be. And that might sound silly, but I manage multiple channels. Or like some of you, I also have multiple channels for different purposes. And so I always check the little picture to make sure I'm logged in correctly. And so here I'm gonna make sure I'm logged in as Social Blade before I upload my video, because I don't want it on the wrong channel. Now, after I've done that, I am of course going to click upload. And you can see here on this screen that you have two ways to upload videos. You can drag and drop, or you can click and it'll open up a file browser and you can select files that way. You can upload one file or multiple files. Just keep in mind that if your videos are high quality and long, you probably wanna do one at a time because it does take them quite a bit longer to upload. Now, what I really want to show you are these privacy settings for your video. You've got four of them here. You want to select these before you upload a video. The first one is public and pretty self-explanatory. That goes out to your entire subscriber feed and it becomes available through search. So never upload a video as public unless it is ready to be seen. Your second option is an unlisted video. Now, anyone can watch this video, but it doesn't go out to your subscriber feed and it's not available through search. So they basically have to have the link to watch the video. So I like this option if I have a video going out that's specifically designed to be embedded on a web page, or if there's a video I really only want to share with a select group of people, but I don't really care if more people get it. Like, I'm okay with them sharing it. So our third option here is a private video. When this video goes up, the only people who can see it are gonna be you and managers of your channel, and also specific people you invite. Now, these people are going to have to be logged into their YouTube or Google accounts to be able to view that video. And so, you know, we use this option for videos that aren't ready for publication yet. Like somebody's gonna do some work on the back end, or we're getting opinions on a video. It's also great if you've got some private information going back and forth, like maybe you're putting together a class or something that you want people to pay for. Our fourth option here is the option that we use the most at Social Blade, and this is a scheduled video. So this goes up as a private video, but you set a future time and date for it to be published. And when that time and date rolls around, well, it publishes. So this is really useful for a couple reasons. One reason is that you can optimize the time and date that you release your videos. For instance, for us, we generally release our videos at 3 p.m. Eastern on weekdays because we found that we get the most number of views at that time. You can also schedule videos, like if you're gonna go on vacation, you kind of maintain that illusion of having a consistent upload schedule. Or like us, we create an entire series at a time, edit them en masse, upload them, and then we just schedule an entire month at a time. So very, very handy to have. So I have a video here, and we're gonna upload it as an unlisted video because it is designed to be embedded on Social Blade's website. So here it is. And so now I've just come to the screen, and all I have to do is set up the metadata. This little bar at the top is going to tell me when it's done processing, and then I just click done. So come join me next time. We're gonna take a look at our video manager and some more things that you can do with your YouTube videos.